some very astute advice to share with us all. So if you're single, perk up your ears. Everybody give it up for Megan Williams!
Definitely played softball in college. That's just newly out. lots of group shots, and between 1 in 3 photos with their mother, who's their best friend. They'll also list that they're looking for activity partners. There is the honest to a fault, heart on sleeve lesbian, most typically a Pisces or Scorpio, who wants to tell you all about it. Other giveaways here include cat photos, a love of urban foraging, and a recommendation for a day trip to the hot springs as a first date idea. There it is, next up, the brusque, hit it and quit it top, who relies on pictures of their aloof good looks and probably of their truck or Jeep, typically a mid to late 90s model, to get you quivering. Now, it's your job to assess these resumes. Here, you're looking for similarities that could lead to long-term bliss, but it's just as important to scan out the non-negotiables. So for instance, for me, when scanning, no cat people. Nobody who's passing through the bay because they were cosmically drawn here. And maybe most importantly, no one who deems it acceptable in any circumstance to post a photo of themselves on the internet in which their tongue is outside of
their
mouth. If you decide to pass a resume on to the next stage of the process, congratulations, this is so exciting. You can invite an applicant to submit an application by way of mutually liking their profile so that they can send you a private message. This is the initial contact. And my goodness, this is important. This is the opportunity for the candidate to both generally woo and specifically reel you in. If they do neither, do not respond. If they nail it, this is really their opportunity to first prove their fitness for the position of potential partner. Some questions to keep in mind when reviewing messages. First, does their humor translate well in written communication? Two, do they take some risks, but still demonstrate realistic caution and logic? Three, do they take the time to review and spell check that shit? We're a spell check now. I've learned something about the application stage of the process. I'm going to share it now. If a candidate is phoning it in at this point, they're likely to continue to disappoint you. To dip back into the professional recruiting realm for a moment, this looks like responding to job application questions with a cocky, lazy, please see resume. For any job seekers in the audience, don't do that. Also bullshit. Just write an answer. So, again, laziness with dating applicants comes across in some pretty typical categories. Let's discuss them. First, flattery category. You're really hot. We should hang. Astute and pithy. Giants are killing it, huh? You like sports? back in 2010. No, that wasn't. Would you rather have sex with C-3PO or R2-D2? Stop it. Just stop it. Now, frankly, there's a lot of steps here that I'm going to skip because they're cumbersome, and we all know what an absolute hell it can be to go through text and email correspondence with a stranger. Actually, based on that reaction, I think there might be some folks in the room who don't know this experience. Okay. So I'm going to give you folks an opportunity to build some empathy tonight. After the show, grab your phone. Send a text message to 2 or 3 completely random phone numbers. And then just try to keep that text conversation going long enough to establish whether that stranger could significantly contribute to your happiness for the rest of your life. Watch your empathy grow. Finally, we arrive at the date. To do this well, to be your best recruiter and set your candidate up for success, you'll need to be under 18. The trick is to make them comfortable. Eye contact, but not too much. A glass of water, something stronger. Start with the easy questions. How was your day? What do you do? Oh, you biked here. Cool, what route? How long have you lived in the Bay? I know, I can't imagine leaving either. Remain in control, but let them believe this is an equally guided journey you're on. If they're nervous, tell them a funny story about your day. Or better yet, a completely monotonous one. It's helpful to remind them that you're no more interesting than they are. If they're really, really nervous, lie. Tell them you're nervous, too. Smile big, turn your body in, take care of the first round, stroke the ego just enough, and then share 2 to 3 warm, bite-sized pieces of yourself. After a few minutes of this, they'll have no problem relaxing. Their shoulders will drop, they'll breathe more deeply, they'll smile. They'll be comfortable in their own skin because of the work that you've done. They'll be putty in your hands. You didn't think this was going to go beyond that, did you? You didn't think I was going to share how my recruiting prowess had led me to land the ultimate hire.
Yeah.
I told you I could share about dating as a 30-some-odd-year-old queer woman in the Bay. I have delivered. Here's the thing, friends. I know that this is not how it works. I know that systems and categories only get you so far. I know it's not about channeling candidates through some funnel of assessment, and it is certainly not a numbers game. I know that love creeps in. I know that love sneaks up, blindsides you when you're completely distracted. I know that it can be hidden over here in your peripheral vision until it moves at just the right time as you happen to be glancing left. But I can't keep lunging around corners trying to chase some shadow, and I certainly can't be glancing at strangers just hoping one of them will mouth, So, in the meantime, until the stars align to bring me my honest to a fault, old truck driving, girl next door, whose tongue always remains inside her mouth when photos are painted, and who deeply and inherently understands that dogs always trump cats.
Yes, they do.
I'll play the game. Message by message and date by date, I'll learn a little bit more about myself and a little bit more about what I love in other people. And in case it wasn't clear, and please do write this down to share with your friends later, I'm single.